kilometers to the northeast of Nagorno-Karabakh, and this is what used to be an Armenian bunker and a military post. This area, of course, has now been liberated by the Azerbaijani forces. The Armenians have left, but what the Azerbaijani forces are doing at the moment is they're minesweeping this area. They're saying that as the Armenians were leaving, they've laid out a mesh of mines around this area, and this is why civilians are not allowed around this area. This used to be a kitchen of the Armenian forces as they were occupying this area. Now, this is quite a large military outpost. The tunnel that I've emerged from, the other end of that tunnel comes out around 30 meters in this direction. So it seems that they've created a network of tunnels around here to move around, quite well fortified. And as the Armenians were leaving, they've left behind some traces. For example, here we have a magazine from an assault rifle lying around. Now, the Armenian forces were required to completely withdraw from the Kalbajar district of Nagorno-Karabakh by the 15th of November. They've sought extension and they've been granted 10 more days. That's until the 25th of November. The Azerbaijani forces are saying that they are now going to be leaving areas like Lachin and Adam in the coming days. And what the Armenians have been doing as they've been withdrawing from many of those areas is setting houses on fire. We've seen pictures of at least one school that's been set ablaze, and also they've been setting many forests around that area on fire. The Azerbaijani government says that's a case of eco-terrorism, and the international community needs to take notice of that. So that evacuation process is continuing as we speak, and the government of Azerbaijan says once that evacuation is complete, then they're going to be carrying out a detailed assessment, demining the area, and then there's going to be the phase of reconstruction before the internally displaced people are able to return home.